Christ.
Yes.
And allow God to use everything that comes to us. The Bible says, "For I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a good hope and a good future." That's Jeremiah 29:11. Now, if God said it, that settles it. Amen? The battle is not ours. It's the Lord. We are set up for a step up in Christ. We are set up for a step up in Christ. Every setback is a step up in Christ. Every setback is a step up in Christ. Say it with me. Every setback is a step up in Christ. Every setback is a step up in Christ. When the setbacks come, plant your feet like this and say, "I am being set up for a step up in Christ." Amen? Amen. I am being set up for a step up in Christ.
Amen.
And remember David, because when David went out with those provisions, he had no clue. He was being set up by God to be step up further in Christ. He had no clue, but he knew the tools that he had. 5 smooth stones, a slingshot, and his rod. And he used the tools that he had. Don't be afraid of the setbacks. Don't be afraid of the setbacks. The Bible also teaches that God knows us before we're formed in our mother's womb, Jeremiah 1:5. You know, we also have to recognize a couple other things. My brother, my sisters, if you don't learn anything else today, learn this, that those of us that are saved, that when anything comes against us, they're coming against God's angels as well. Appreciate the setbacks.
Yes.
Because it facilitates to step up, you know, and be ready for the step up. And let's talk a little bit. Let's bring this thing home for a second. You know, let's just bring it in. Brothers, let's bring this in for a moment. You know, we've heard so much about these celebrities dropping dead. We had Michael Fall dropping dead. We had Farrah Fawcett. We had Steve McNair. We had Billy Mays dropped dead, just to name Carl McFarland dropped dead, just to name a few of them that's more familiar. But let me tell you something. Michael Jackson being the primary person that dropped dead. Michael's problem too was he was so arrogant and thought he was in control of his life. He got a doctor on staff thinking a doctor was going to save him.
Mercy.
But he cannot do that. The only person that can save you is Jesus the Christ. He's the one that determines your comings and your goings. He's the one that determines when you live and when you die. You can have 10 doctors of the highest esteem around you. But if it's your time to go, you're out of here. You are so out of here. It is not man's determination. It is God's. So I beg to differ with all of the medical professionals that we might have in the hearing of my voice. You do not determine when someone lives, and no one has an expiration date that you can see. Because only God determines when you expire.
Yes.
He will tell you when, and only when he says so, it is so.
Yes.
Nothing else determines that but God. You know, Bernie Mac died last year. I love Bernie Mac's TV show, whatever it's called, I forget it right now, but I love his show.
The Bernie Mac show,
exactly right. I loved him, and he died last year, August the 9th. I was in Europe when he passed. And you know, one of the things that brought home to me, he was 49 years old, he wasn't even quite 50. Michael Jackson was 50, Billy Mays was 50. There seems to be a thing going on in spirit that God is letting us know. God is letting us know that he don't care who you are. He is no respecter of persons. You know, so if nothing else, live right. Believe in God. Commit your life to him and you will be all right. If you don't, you'll be like, Matt McNair, you know, Stephen McNair, shot dead in a rented apartment with a 20-year-old when he should have been home with his wife and four children. Now, let me tell you something, you know, sometimes consequences to our sin is swift. They are punishment and consequences to sin. Sometimes it's swift, sometimes it's not. But be aware it is coming. There is consequences to sin. And God will not let you tarry too long. Sometimes he lets you go a long time. And other times he snaps you out just like that. Matt Neer didn't know what was going to happen. He was there with his girlfriend, 20 years old, in a rented condo. She thinks she had it going on. Yeah, but guess what? God had something else. Today your soul is required. He was out of here. Out of here. Sin has punishment and consequences. Sometimes it's swift, sometimes it's not. But rest assured, it is coming. It is coming. Repent. 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 Turn away from your sins and ask God for forgiveness, and he will forgive you. Turn over a new slate. Repent. Jesus is coming back. You don't want to come back and find you with your knickers, as we say in the English vernacular, at your ankles.
Right.
You don't want your knickers to be at your ankles. You want your knickers to be at your waist. Be aware he is coming back.
Yes.
Repent. Repent. Amen. Repent and ask for forgiveness. God will forgive you. He will give you a new life, a new heart. Believe Jesus Christ. Recognize that he is able to do all but fail. He loves you with an unbelievable love. And in his arms is peace unbelievable. Recognize that we are all sinners saved by grace. I am no better than you are. I'm just repentant. I am repentant. And I'd ask God to forgive me of my sins and to come into my heart. And that's the only difference from us, from those who are not saved. It's nothing magical. It's just a repentant heart. Realizing that you're sin and you've been asking God to forgive you and to come into your heart. Repent. Say, God, forgive me. I have sinned and come into my heart. That's all God asks of you to do. And when you have done that, he'll move upon your life and you will be changed in the twinkling of an eye. You become a new creature and you won't even realize what's going on until you say, wow, I'm not cursing anymore. I don't have the desire for things I used to do to me anymore. And you're like, wait a minute, what happened? Jesus happened.
Jesus, right.
Jesus happened. Jesus happened. Jesus happened. Jesus happened. At the name of Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue is going to confess that Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus, for saving us. Thank you, Lord, for believing that we are worthy of the redemptive blood. Jesus came on, died on the cross. Something that's for thieves. Something that was for people that were horrible. It was the worst kind of death that they could have done back then. And he died that way for me. He died that way for you to be redeemed. That his blood can be shed and you can be restored. Don't let it go by without you being redeemed. Believe Jesus. Believe Jesus. Come, ask him to come into your life. Right now, nothing is stopping you for changing your life. Believe God is asking to forgive you right now. With all eyes closed and all heads bowed, we're going to go to the Lord right now in prayer. Those under the sound of my voice and those within earshot of me, wherever you are, in your house, in your tent doors, listening.